Next question is from Heidi. And Heidi asked, is there trauma or wounding on the soul level?
Yes. Now the soul is not a thing, but the psychic being is the thing that can be wounded. Psychic trauma is usually corresponding with psychological trauma, but it can exist independent of any circumstances of your life that would otherwise create trauma. A psychic trauma has a validity, it has a truth. But the soul itself and the jivatman that's linked to the soul principle itself is not a thing, it's a doorway to no thing. The more that we live in that principle of soul, the less trauma can stay with us, because it is that which, like a black hole, just all trauma disappears in it. So the nature of human psychological trauma, however, can have its roots that go as far deep as psychic trauma, which occurs when a newborn being has an awareness, a greater awareness than normal, usually an advanced soul that takes a life, carries a certain quality of psychic beingness, alertness, in the field of alertness, where it's more easily overtaken, because it's not yet, the person in the body is not yet organized as an individual. Therefore, it gets taken this way and that way, and it doesn't know itself in the process of getting overcome by psychic signals. Now, for some, this can actually become very, very disturbing if the environment carries violent, distressing, threatening vibrations. Child doesn't know the events, but if there is parents arguing, loud noise happening, strange occurrence popping up, then there is this kind of getting hypersensitivity that starts developing, where the individual cannot organize as an individual without carrying some degree of fear and reaction. And therefore, it creates an instability in the organization of the person as it matures as a person, as it goes through, you know, being a baby to being a young child, and so on and so forth. Outwardly, there does not need to be a lot of factors. That can be one of the causes of psychic trauma, because it will obviously continuously be reactivated, because the human, as the person develops psychologically, it will take the onslaught as a reactivation of the early traumatic event. There are solutions to psychic trauma, but that can occur until a person has organized enough in their own self-awareness and their own understanding of themselves and the world that they can become aware of how to develop protections and boundaries, basically, about what they take in and what they don't take in, to separate themselves from what is being injected into the field of their attention. So that said, it can also happen that there can be an event which rends the field of a developing soul. It could happen when you're 3 or 6 or 7 or 15. You could 20, you could take a drug, and the drug could come in and you could rent the veil of the bubble of your, what we call the aura, which is the field of energetic field that kind of is associated with our identity, like the solar system is associated with the sun. That could be ruptured. And if that's ruptured, then what can come in is forces that would not otherwise, that would be too much for our state of consciousness. And we could feel threatened or overtaken and create a disruption, which will create distortions, feelings of exalted power, feelings of collapse, diminishment, the extremes of the vital nature that could create pain and physical symptoms in the physical. It can create mental incoherence, madness through the mental. You know, it can create deep emotional, profound openings and threats, profound collapses in the emotional nature. So this all can happen as part of psychic trauma, which can be independent of what we call psychological trauma, and they're often intertwined in that. Okay, so you can understand the nature of that. Now, what is the healing of that? That's another whole conversation, which we can talk about later. But there are techniques where you use your awareness to be able to create boundaries for yourself and in the current present state of your identity and begin to strengthen the part of you that can begin to heal the torn fabric of your aura and claim its territory for itself and separate from other influences that are unwanted. But the other thing that can happen is you can link up on this when you awaken spiritually, which, by the way, a good number of people who come to me awaken spiritually carry psychic trauma, and it immediately gets soothed in the field of the teacher because it strengthens the core identity that arises from your psychic being itself rather than egoic identity, which has a limited capacity to meet these kinds of psychic trauma. And there, so there becomes this automatic from within to outside healing and integration of that field that created a problem of unwanted influences. All right, well, that's enough on that conversation, but it opens the door for a way for you to just look for yourself. But you can't know, and knowing this would not necessarily be helpful, but rather staying true to the awakening process that you are on and trust that these things do resolve themselves in time as long as you stay and connected to that divinity that's awakening in you.